It was as if the entire Hey Munchies, it's the Gamer Untamed, and today I have a film review for you guys, and that is going to be on Suffragette, which stars Carey Mulligan, Meryl Streep, and Helena Bonham Carter, so I hope you enjoy.
Women should not exercise judgment in political affairs.
If we allow women to vote, it will mean the loss of social structure.
Vote for women! Vote for women! Vote for women!
A suffragette is a woman seeking the right to vote through organized protests. And in 1903, Emmeline Pankhurst founded the Women's Social and Political Union, which advocated for the extension of the franchise to women. And the franchise includes the right to vote, the right to entitlements, and the right to her own child. Were it not for the sacrifice of devoted suffragette Emily Davison, the women's suffrage movement in England would not have gained the martyr that led to women over the age of 30 being granted the right to vote in 1918, which was extended to all women over the age of 21 in 1928. Suffragette addresses the paucity of spirit that loomed over the city of London in the early 20th century, while illustrating the asperity of the torment and anguish writhed at the expense of many middle-class and proletarian women.
This film is led by women, directed by women, produced by women. That's a really rare thing. It's not a common occurrence for a film like this to be made, let alone about this subject matter.
Vote for women. Power is in your hands.
No one cares, love.
Some of us do, Mrs. Coleman. So it's like you're bleeding cake hole.
It's not a film strictly about politics or about sitting in a room hashing out issues. It's about action. And that was the point. They were going to get stuff done by being heard and being louder than everybody else.
This film is about women gaining a voice, wanting a voice, fighting for a voice.
The need to vote and the need for female equality has never felt more personal and more relevant to be discussed.
We have reached a state of anarchy we can no longer ignore. Punish those responsible.
These are people who have a cause for which they would lay down their lives.
Here were a group of women fighting inequality, turning to acts of civil disobedience to achieve it. It all felt incredibly exciting and resonant. This was the time to tell this story.
The fight for equality and the right to vote was deemed condemned and ill-fated. For many stalwart suffragettes were risking their jobs, their lives, their families, and their homes for the sake of a just cause. Placed in the hands of a woman, director Sarah Gavron has created an historic film that encapsulates the essence of what it meant to be a woman trapped inside a patriarchal society. It is worth noting that Suffragette is not a film targeted towards the male demographic. It is hardly astonishing that these former autocratic oppressors would be so inclined to attend a film that depicts men as callous persecutors with an inherent lack of empathy towards the female population. Suffragette follows the personal storyline of Maud Watts, played by Carey Mulligan, wife, mother, and laundry factory worker. In retrospect, the narrative is nothing more than a recounted book report of historic events. However, as the story is told through the eyes of a character that is able to generate the sympathies of the audience, Suffragette is more than just a tedious and plain narrative. Scriptwriter Abby Morgan vividly depicts the atrocities agonized by women in the early 1900s, which significantly tugged on my heartstrings, led to an emergence of streaming tears and smudged mascara. Tip number one, do not wear makeup in a cinema, especially in a movie that you think you may cry in, like this one. Emotionally stimulating, factually poignant, and desperately tearful, while the film may not be explicitly spectacular or impressive, it does not detract from the many demoralizing and alarming on-screen moments that are transparently akin to that of history. Stylistically authentic, with the austerity of the industrialized factories, dominated by tinges of cobalt and black soot, and the bleak, clouded atmosphere of the streets of the East End, it was as if the entire set was ripped from the pages of a history book, and it was fantastic to witness. The combination of the setting and costume design convincingly evoke a bygone age, which is not pacified by vibrant vistas and garish garments. Unfortunately, excluding the hectically shot sequence of chaos and pandemonium and anarchy outside Parliament, I believe, the cinematography and soundtrack fail to rise above mediocre, which is very disappointing because I love soundtracks and music is such an incredibly important part of a narrative. It was rather subtle in the storyline, but I felt like it was not as evoking or stimulating as the rest of as the storyline and as the performance of the actors. Carey Mulligan portrays the character of Maud Watts with a euphoric and boisterous sense of exigency, as it is through her that Abby Morgan confronts the audience with the horrific extent of the suffering endured by many of the women during this era. Maud is in prison, thrown on the streets by her abashed husband, Sonny Watts, played by Ben Whishaw, is removed from her beloved son, who was instead adopted into another family, and is force-fed food via a tube through her nose in order to prevent her from striking over a period of 5 days. What? Like, I was a little confused. I mean, I suppose it's easier to throw up the food if you're putting it down your throat, but oh my god, I did not expect this to see this. It was excruciatingly difficult to watch. I remember just sitting there like, oh my god, what am I doing? Why am I here? It was just terrifying, and the torment and the struggle that you could see Maud go through after when she's losing her son and she's trying to keep him and hold on to him for as long as possible. It is excruciatingly painful to watch.
Mother's name is Maud Watts. Don't forget that name. Because I'll be waiting for you to find me. Will you find me, George? Don't forget it.
Come on.
No.
Come on, George.
No.
Let him go. I'll take him.
Cast excel in their depictions of their individual characters. Some of the cast include Helena Bonham Carter, Anne-Marie Duff, Brendan Gleeson, Ben Whishaw, and many others. However, Meryl Streep, who plays Miss Emmeline Pankhurst, who manages to invoke unity and devotion among the very passionate suffragette women, has one scene in this film. She's referenced multiple times, but she only appears once, and the time in which she appears in amounts to about 5 minutes. So as the top-billed actress for this film, I was incredibly disappointed with this revelation. I assumed she'd be in it multiple times, but no, she's not. Never surrender, never give up the fight is all she says, or she says some other things, but that's all she leaves you with, and then she leaves, and then Maud and Edith and Violet are, you know, put in prison. Thank you. Suffragette is a modest and simplistic creation which does not require the grandeur of extravagant cinematography to convey the austerity of an era where women were secondary to men. All that you need is a cast of fantastic actors and you'll be right. This film is fantastically brutal, emotionally provocative, and remains fiercely honest and true to its time. This film is a feminist production, but I'm not saying that it lacks heart and soul. Just because of that, it is a fantastic film. It is really, really great. I wish it were better than just a recount, but that is what it is. A lot of historic films do follow the same pathway. And for that reason, I am going to give this film a... Ooh, where's it going? 7 out of 10. I'm not saying it's bad. It's a really great film. And there have been lots of Oscar buzz for Carey Mulligan around. We'll see. It doesn't have as much punch and punitiveness as Selma did, but we'll see how it goes. Suffragette is a history lesson being told through the eyes of a character that the audience can sympathize with. Were it not for the construction of such humanly relatable characters, I don't believe this film would have even entered as an Oscar contender. And that is the end of my review. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give it a like if you did. Give it one anyway. Subscribe if you haven't already. Don't forget to share this video. Leave your comments down below of what you thought of this film, if you've seen it or if you might like to go see it. And Happy New Year, everyone, because I'm making this on the 1st. But it'll come out on the 2nd for everyone else, I think, or the 3rd if you're in Australia. I don't know time conversions. I'm still trying. But I hope you guys have a wonderful week. Until I see you next, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye!